Hello everyone, what's up, everybody? It's Ben in my Pokemon form, and today I'm going to be doing part 3 of my reaction to I Should Be Alive Alone in the Amazon. So if you guys missed part 2, go watch that before you watch this one, but this will be part 3. So I hope you guys put this up, hit the subscribe button, turn on post notifications, and let's get started.
For hours, Benedict fights his way through the jungle. But as night falls, he can go no further. And when the sun goes down, the searing temperatures plummet. So he makes a shelter, using a technique he learned from his guides. Sweating away, and then felt incredibly cold. The brutal reality is that Benedict isn't prepared for this at all. In the 100% humidity, he has no way of keeping dry or warm. And with his mosquito net gone, no way to protect himself against the deadly disease he fears the most, malaria. Then the insects started moving in, and a long night began.
To fire and dry out my clothes just to fend off this chlorine wetness which wore you down. I felt very burdened by the forest. I just thought, I've got to get out of this place.
Benedict resumes his hike towards the outside world, but so far has only managed 4 of the 100 miles he has to traverse. It's been 4 days since he last ate, and he's beginning to weaken.
I was starting to feel hunger pains. And I knew that unless I sorted out some sort of way of getting food, I was just going to die of starvation. I started to think how I could get nourishment from this place that seemed intent on killing me. So I thought, okay, I've got to settle myself down and build a few traps.
And Benedict knows that if you want to trap an animal, you have to find its trail.
Make 2 parallel lines of sticks that you jam into the forest floor and you funnel the mouse along. And there's a little bit of bait that you put at the end and it triggers a mechanism and boom, a log comes down and flattens the mouse and you get this flat rodent for your supper. So time-consuming to even fashion these things, but waiting for an animal to come along, I found absolutely exasperating. I thought, I'm totally incompetent here. I don't belong in the forest, and furthermore, the forest seems to know it.
like I've been found out. Every species here has learned to survive, and those that aren't good enough die. And I'm going to be next, because I don't know how to cope here. I can't even make a simple trap. I began to dread every evening. It was a question of trying to light fires, then I had to find water to boil so I could drink it. And all of this was taking time when I was already exhausted from trying to make progress through the forest. To dread the loneliness of night and wish for the morning again, but in the morning, no relief. I felt like a hamster on a treadmill heading to nowhere.
And skip the whole thing, so we can...
Benedict has managed to fight his way through 25 miles of jungle. A mere quarter of the distance he believes he needs to travel to reach the outside world. The only food he's eaten are the tips of ferns, but it's not enough. And he's beginning to experience the first effects of starvation.
My hunger was really bad. I felt weak. I was doing less and less miles every day, and feeling more and more confused.
And weakened by hunger, his body is becoming too frail to withstand the jungle's constant onslaught.
Insects were more of a problem, and so were the bites. Some of them were starting to fester and weep. All of this was sort of visible evidence that I was being attacked. Suddenly, there was a palm tree. It was a marajah palm. And I remembered how my guides had taken the berries and they made a wonderful purple mush. Suddenly I had all the energy in the world because I saw hope now.
Oh boy.
I drank down this wonderful, nutritious liquid. God, it felt so good to have my stomach full.
But though...
unable to digest this rich berry pulp. And as starvation takes a stranglehold, his body is beginning to break down.
It was a terrible situation because on the one hand, I could eat, but if I did eat, I'd feel more sick. It didn't seem to be solving any problem, and it was a sort of hellish situation.
Despite his sickness, Benedict pushes onwards, but he's getting weaker by the hour, and it's not just the result of malnutrition.
Gradually, I realized I was succumbing to something. Sweat was becoming more and more obvious to me. Looking at my hand, I'd see it shaking and shaking. Destroying Benedict's red blood cells, starving his body and brain of
Alright guys, thanks for watching. If you guys like this video, give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and leave a comment. Subscribe to your channel is my same thing, and yeah, guys, again, I'm almost close to 520 subscribers. 520 subscribers, that's a lot. For your goal, I really appreciate it. Please again, this video is close to my goal, reach 1,000 subscribers, and for those watching. I really appreciate it. Please again, thank you for all you guys. I love you guys so much for all your support. Like I always say, and I always mean. And yeah, also if you guys want to watch this, it was made by Alt Documentary. I'll put the link to their video down in the description. If you guys want to watch it. But yeah, alright guys, there you go. Thanks so much for watching. Please like this video, leave a comment, subscribe for more, and I'll catch you guys for later for part 4. On my reaction to I Shouldn't Be Alive Alone in the Amazon. Alright guys, there you go. Goodbye. Have a good day or night.